guys, it's Amira and welcome back to my channel. So today I'm going to be showing you how to make focaccia bread using whole wheat flour. Now I love focaccia bread and one of you guys had requested me to make something savory or something spicy, I'm not sure. But I hope that this is good enough and yes, you can put the toppings of your choice. So make it super spicy if you want. I do not eat a lot of spice. Stuff, so sorry. And without further ado, let's go ahead and let's get started. Okay, so first in a small bowl, we're going to start by activating our yeast. So in here, you're going to add in 80 ml of lukewarm water. Now your water should not be too hot because you want to activate the yeast, not kill it. And yes, I don't know how many cups would that be, hence 80 ml of water. And to that you're going to add in a teaspoon of sugar. So this is to feed our yeast. And now to this we are finally going to be adding in our yeast. So we need 1.5, which is 1.5 teaspoon of yeast. So 1.5. Is that half teaspoon? There it goes. And now you're just going to mix this. Now you're going to set this mixture aside for 10 to 15 minutes until it gets nice and foamy and like bubbly. Wrap yourselves a nice big bowl. This is the bowl where we'll be combining our dough, so make sure it's a nice and big bowl. And to this you're going to add in 1.5 cup of whole wheat flour. You can use all-purpose flour too if you want to. And to that you are going to, first you have to make a well. So just make a little well for your liquid ingredients. That looks good enough. Next, we are going to add in our olive oil. So, olive oil is the oil you usually use for focaccia bread. That's just what we're going to be using today as well. So, you need 2 tablespoons of olive oil. Yeah, that looks great. And yeah, that's pretty much what we want to do at this point. I totally forgot we had to add in our salt as well. So you need 3/4 of a teaspoon, which would be 1/2 + 1/4 teaspoon. So you can adjust the salt according to your taste, but I find this measurement right. So this you do not want to add in the salt in the well. That's because salt actually kills your yeast. So you're just going to add it in the side. A little bit went there, but that's fine. And another 1/4 teaspoon is what we need. There we go. And now you're just going to like leave this here. And then I'll tell you what to do with this salt. Just leave it on the side at the next to your next to your flour mixture, you're going to add in 1/2 teaspoon of oregano. This is optional, but it adds great flavor. So I'm just going to add that into the side as well. And now you wait for your yeast to get nice and bubbly. Okay, so now to this, we're going to add in 2 cloves of garlic. So you could use 4 cloves too. As you can see, mine are quite big, so you might want to use 4. Also, do not skip on this step if you're planning to do that, because garlic will add amazing flavor to your bread. So now I'm just going to grate this. Okay, so guys, I added in the garlic and the yeast mixture is looking great. That's what you want. So yeah, now we are ready to combine our dough. I'm just going to give this a little mix. Okay, that's looking great. So now you're going to add the yeast mixture in between. And try to get all of that in there, because this is what will make your bread nice and fluffy. So that's looking great. And now you're going to start bringing the dough together. So I like to start with a metal spoon. And yes, you do have to work with it using your hands eventually. But I like to just give it a little start with the metal spoon. And about the salt and pepper, yeah, now just like cover it up with some of that flour. And then basically you're trying to mix these two things separately. So once you've done something like this, then feel free to mix these in as well. That's looking great. And now here I have an 1/8 cup of whole milk. This is whole milk that is warm. So you're just going to gradually add it in. You might not need all of it, but we're just using the milk to help us bring the dough together. And now I'm going to start using my hands. I just like to use the metal spoon for the salt part because that's kind of nerve-wracking, if you will. And yeah, I'm just going to bring this dough together. I'm going to start a time lapse so that you guys can see, but you don't get bored at the same time. Okay, so guys, I was bringing the dough together and I realized that I told you need 1/8 cup of milk, but I'm so sorry, my mistake, you need 1/4 cup of milk. I just got a little confused. So that's how you're going to bring your dough together. Okay, so guys, my dough is ready, and yes, you can use a dough hook to do this, but I kneaded it in using my hands in front of you guys. So yes, you can do this by hand too. And if you're hoping that you'd be getting a smooth dough at this point, no guys, do not hope for that because the gluten hasn't relaxed yet. So you might notice when you're like trying to shape your dough like this, it'll be tearing. That's what happens when your gluten isn't relaxed. So now we're just going to prep our bowl so that we can put this dough ball and let it sit, you know, let it just have some time to adjust. Okay. So to prep your bowl, I guess, you're just going to add in a little bit of olive oil. Actually, be generous, guys. Focaccia bread is like, the more oil, the better. And just grease your bowl nicely. I'm just using my hands because I just kneaded a dough, so I'm already quite messy. Okay, and once you've done that, just take your dough ball and roll that around in the oil as well. And yeah, that's basically all. Okay, so now guys, you're just going to cover your dough using a kitchen towel, tea towel, and now you're just going to put this in a nice warm corner and let it be there for about 1 to 2 hours. This will rise up and it'll be a lot more smoother. I'm just going to put this in my microwave because my microwave does have an option for doughs. And yeah, I'll see you guys in an hour. Okay, so our dough is done. It has been resting for about 1 hour and 30 minutes. So yeah, it's looking great. And I'm just going to deflate it. That feels really soft. Okay. Now you don't want to overwork it because you don't want to toughen up the gluten. You want the gluten to be relaxed. So just grab yourselves a baking dish or a baking tray. I'm using this 7-inch one. And now you're just going to add in a lot of olive oil in here. And by a lot, I do mean a lot, guys. So be generous. Okay, that's enough for now. And yeah, you're just going to spread it around. And at this point, I do like to use my hands because we are going to be working with the dough anyways. So yeah, it's fine. But you can use a pastry brush if you're fancy. So as you can see, all the oil is kind of stuck in the corner. So I'm just going to move my pan around a little, trying to distribute the oil as much as I can. And yeah, I'll see you guys when I'm done with that. Okay, so this is looking pretty evenly distributed. So now you're going to grab your dough and just plop that in, I guess. And now you're going to spread it out as evenly as possible. Try to make the shape of your pan and get into the corners. And if your dough is like shrinking back when you're trying to spread it, then don't worry. Just let your dough relax for another 10 or 20 minutes and it'll be fine. And you should be able to work with it. Okay, so this is looking pretty good. And it has enough space to rise as well. But I'm just going to even it out a little bit more. Okay, so I evened this out as much as I could. And now we're going to poke holes. This is my favorite part. So you just need a little bit more olive oil. Now this time don't go too crazy. So I just like to use a capful, about a teaspoon. And now you're just going to poke these holes in here like this. So you don't want to reach like the bottom, but you want to make these holes. That's just the traditional shape, I guess. And yeah, and the oil will basically sit in here. So at this point, feel free to add in any toppings of your choice, like tomatoes, basil, olives, but I'm just going to leave it plain because yeah, that's what I'm doing. And yeah, that's pretty much done. And now that this dough is ready, before we cook it off, you're going to take your towel and just cover it and let it rest for another 30 minutes or so. I know this is a lot of waiting, guys, but trust me, the end result is so worth it. This is going to be absolutely delicious. So yeah, I'm just going to let it sit at room temperature now and this should rise once again. Okay, so guys, it has been about 40 minutes and the dough has risen, as you guys can see. And now you're just going to preheat your microwave to 180 degrees Celsius and bake your bread on a rack, like a baking rack, at 180 degrees Celsius for anywhere between 35 to 40 minutes. So guys, when I said to bake it on a rack, here's what I meant. My microwave was done preheating, so I placed the highest rack and I put the baking tray pan over it, and that's how it's baking. So as you can see, it's quite top. It's quite close to the top, and that's what you want so that it can get quite a lot of heat and bake.
Okay, easy. So guys, the focaccia bread was baked and now I'm walking to the kitchen and it's super dark. There we go. Yeah, so I let it cool for about half an hour. I got a little carried away and now let's release it from the pan.
Now, because of all the olive oil we put in there, it's super easy to remove the bread. You are just going to run a knife around the corners. And after you've done that, you should be able to release your bread. So just take the plate of your choice and just put it on. Wait, I'll just adjust the camera a little. There we go. Okay, so now you're just going to take a plate and basically put the plate on top of your pan and just flip it. And there you go, you have your focaccia bread and now you can just lift it up and flip it back. And there we go, it's looking so pretty and I love the way it turned out. Okay, so now let's cut into it. It's so pretty, I really don't want to cut into it. I started cutting and I thought that I had started my camera, but apparently I didn't. So yeah, it's pretty easy to cut into this if you have a sharp knife, like you need a sharp knife to cut it. And look at that. We made this using whole wheat flour. It is definitely a healthier option and it just looks amazing.
Okay, so guys, it has been hours and I have been wanting to eat focaccia bread and it's finally time. Now I am going to cut my piece into half because I'm pretty sure I shouldn't be eating that much bread at this point of the day. So yes, it's okay, you know, I'll have the remaining in the morning. I'm pretty sure it won't last for 5 minutes too. So yeah, there we go. Here's the bread. And I mean, I really love the texture and it's super soft and it has the crispy edge. And now I'm going to stop blabbering and let's eat. I have no words. Speechless. It's just so. It's just. I don't want to say perfect, but guys, I'm sorry, it is perfect. Perfect amount of seasoning, perfect amount of salt, and the wheat flour just makes it so. I love it. This is my dinner. Make sure to like this video for the focaccia bread because it's very good. Subscribe, ring the bell, and I'll see you all next time. Goodbye. I'm just gonna get the camera now.